Helmets and airbrushing go hand in hand. So in this video, I'm going to give you guys a couple tips and tricks for masking off your helmets. Pretty much all helmets have a trim that runs around where the outer shell and the inner liner are connected. You can see the trim piece running around the bottom side of this half helmet. You can also see the trim running around the bottom side of this full-faced helmet. Most of the time, that trim piece is made out of either hard plastic or kind of a rubbery, softer material. Sometimes, it's pretty rare in my experience, but sometimes you can actually find a helmet where you can remove that trim piece. Most of the time, that is not an option. That's not the case with this helmet. I'm not gonna try and remove this trim piece because this is on pretty good and I don't wanna mess with having to re-glue it on later. So the first step in this process is going to be masking off that trim, and I'm gonna do that with a roll of half inch masking tape. Now I'm going to try and do this upside down so that you can see a little bit better in the camera. The main thing is on this trim, and I'll show you on this full face helmet because it's a little bit easier to see. So you have all this black is the trim. And the one thing that I want to do is I don't want to mask the trim off all the way up to the top edge. I'm going to cut that about in half. So the half inch masking tape, just pick a place to start. And again, I'm not masking this all the way up to the top of that trim. I'm leaving about half of the trim still exposed, and I'll explain why I'm doing that here in just a little bit. I like the half inch masking tape because it's a little bit easier to wrap around corners and curves, which are a big part of a motorcycle helmet. Make sure you burnish your tape down good. I'm just working all the way around this trim, just masking off the lower edge. Again, burnishing this down. Make sure it's stuck to this plasticky, rubbery surface as good as I can get it. And then I'll fold over the bottom edge. Like so. The biggest issue when it comes to painting and or airbrushing a helmet, in my mind, is the fact that we're working on a rounded surface. Oftentimes we need to move the helmet around in order to do what we do. The downside of that is you don't necessarily want to touch the surface that you're working on any more than you absolutely have to. Your hands will transfer oils and other contaminants onto your painting surface, which can cause issues down the road. You can wear gloves. The gloves will protect from transferring the oils, but you can still transfer other contaminants onto the surface. It's just a better idea not to touch the surface if you can absolutely avoid it. So the solution that I've always come up with that works great, and it's stupid cheap and easy, is using an empty gallon metal can. It doesn't matter what was in the can before. If it's empty, this used to be full of DX330. It's wax and grease remover for PPG. You can use an empty clear gallon canister. You can use an empty thinner, empty reducer cans. It doesn't matter, but a gallon can works great. And this will work with a half helmet or a full-faced helmet. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck the straps up in, and I'm going to set the helmet right on top of the can. this point, I'll go to my 2-inch masking tape.
So what I'm going to do is tear off about a 6 to 8 inch piece of this 2-inch masking tape. I'm going to overlap the trim on the helmet, burnishing it down good, and then I'm going to attach the bottom half to the empty gallon container. Now I'll flip this around and do the same thing. On the other side. And when I put the helmet on the gallon container, I try to make the helmet as level as possible, like it would be on the head when somebody is wearing it. It just makes it easier for lining up graphics later. Continuing the same process, go to the front. And finally to the back. Now from here, I'm going to keep doing the exact same thing all the way around the helmet until I have all of this area up underneath covered with tape, because I don't want paint or especially clear coat to get up into the actual liner of the helmet. And checking to make sure you've got your gaps covered. And if you miss a gap here or there, you can always go back over it once we finish the majority of the taping process. Like I said, this works with either a half helmet or a full face helmet. The full face helmet is actually a little bit easier to mask off because you don't have all these curves. And then once you have it all pretty well masked off, you can flip it over and check the bottom. Make sure that you don't have any of those gaps. Normally I will run a strip of tape all the way around. Closes up the bottom pretty well, and then you can use additional tape to cover up any other gaps you might see. That looks pretty good. As far as all of our overhang here now, I'm going to use an X-Acto blade with a brand new blade and very lightly trim the overhang, but I'm only going to cut in the areas where I already had the strip of half inch masking tape before. You want to be very careful not to cut into the actual trim piece. Which is why I highly recommend using a brand new blade. The dull blade you tend to push a little bit harder because it doesn't cut as well, and it's very easy to cut too deep and cut into that liner, and you can't cover that up. If you cut into that plastic liner, you will see it by the time this is finished. This is one of those things that just takes a little bit of practice. But after you've done it a few times, you'll figure out how much pressure is actually needed. And it takes a little more pressure when you have overlapping tape. Some of these I didn't cut through all the way because there were two pieces of tape. This is not a race. Take your time. Do it right the first time. You and your client will be much happier. That looks good.
So now, not only do we have a super cheap and easy secure stand for our helmet, but we can turn this around any direction we need to while we're painting the helmet without ever actually touching the surface that we're working on. So it's a great, cheap, easy way to mount your helmets when you're painting them. Now we come back to why I only masked off about half of this trim piece going around the bottom side of the helmet. That comes down to, I like to double mask this area, the trim piece, because what inevitably will happen is I'm going to have to sand this helmet. This is a used helmet. It's got some nicks and scratches. Even if it was brand new, I would still need to sand it and prime it because this Harley Davidson logo has clear coat over it and you can feel that logo. So I'm going to have to sand it, prime it, and then sand it flat again so that you won't see that logo through the custom paint job that I put on this helmet. When you start sanding this helmet, you can nick the tape with either a Scotch-Brite pad or sandpaper, whichever one you're using. Sometimes you can peel a little bit of it back, and what happens is all that dust will work its way down into that tape, and if you don't get rid of that, it can come back out later when you're spraying through either your airbrush or a spray gun. So I like to sand it, untape the top half of this trim, retape it, I'll prime it, sand it again, and then I'll again remove the top half of the tape around this trim, and then retape it before I begin doing my paint work. You can build up enough paint layers where you'll start to get an edge along your tape and the actual helmet. So depending on how many coats of paint you put on the helmet, you may want to retape the top portion of that trim while you're still painting, or halfway through the process. I think for this helmet, I'll be able to leave the tape on until it's ready to be clear coated. Once it's ready to be clear coated, I'll go ahead and remove the tape and tape it up one more time. So to tape it, because I left about half of it free, so now I'm going to use 1/4 inch masking tape to go around the outside or the top edge of this trim and finish taping that off. I like 1/4 inch tape for this purpose because there are a lot of curves going around this helmet. The 1/4 inch tape bends way easier than the 1/2 inch tape does. This is one of those things that you really want to take your time on. The better tape job you do getting very close to the edge of this trim, the better the end result is going to be. It's a little bit difficult because the trim obviously folds over just a little bit. It sticks out farther than the actual shell does. So I like to use my fingernail to run along that edge. You can probably see there's just a sliver of that trim still showing right there. That's not a big deal. I'll come back and put another piece of tape over that as soon as I get this taped off.
hopefully you can see how much easier it is to bend this quarter inch tape around a curve. You wouldn't be able to do that with a half inch or larger. Made it all the way around. Now I'll make one more pass just to cover anything that didn't get covered. So now I'm going down below where I just taped. That just makes sure I have everything covered so I don't wind up with overspray anywhere that I don't want it. And if you do, it's not the end of the world. You can come back in and clean that up relatively easily, especially with water-based paints. With solvent-based paints, you have to be careful because you can actually dull the finish on that trim. Aside from all that, please use good tape. Don't use the blue painter's tape you find at the big box store or any other cheap tape. Use the tape that was designed for this purpose. Using the correct materials and taking your time, especially when you're masking off that upper trim, no matter how many times you have to mask it off, will produce excellent results in the end. And that's it, my friends. Those are my tips for masking off a helmet before you paint and or airbrush it. I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. If you have questions, leave them in the comments below. I try to answer all of my comments. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and I'll see you guys next week.